saliva is an important fluid for not only for protection of the oral cavity, but in simple things such as enjoying a meal. Patients that have a loss of salivary gland function say it's like trying to eat with a mouthful of sand, not very pleasant. So we've been trying to understand at a fundamental level, what is the trigger that initiates that loss in salivary gland function?
So my goal when studying gene regulation in salivary glands is to better understand an autoimmune disease of those salivary glands. That disease is called Sjögren syndrome.
It primarily affects women, and their salivary glands experience a loss of ability to move water or to move fluid. And this can have a major impact not only on their quality of life, but on their overall health. And there is no current therapy available for it.
You have an immune reaction, but it's spiraled out of control. And if we can identify what the original insult is, we can maybe identify the etiological origin of this autoimmune disease. And we know that the minor salivary glands of individuals with Sjögren syndrome behave differently than the minor salivary glands of individuals that don't have Sjögren syndrome. And so understanding what's going on in the salivary gland and also in those immune cells that are infiltrating the gland is important to understanding the disease.
So an emerging area of imaging technology is something called spatial transcriptomics. And this allows you to look at what genes are turned on, what genes are turned off in a cell in the context of all its neighbors.
Understanding how gene regulation changes in the immune tissue helps us understand why it's damaging the glands potentially in this autoimmune disease.
Testing the idea that you can restore salivary gland function through gene therapy, through other techniques that we're developing. Another important impact that our research has had is in developing a therapy for radiation-induced xerostomia. And what that means is that when you are diagnosed with head and neck cancer, you typically get ionizing radiation, and your salivary glands tend to be in the way of the field of radiation. And while that can be effective, it also can kill a lot of healthy tissue. Patients can be left with a lifetime of dry mouth and oral pain and lots of oral infection. The trial that we're working on is a phase one study to understand the impact of gene therapy in radiation-induced xerostomia patients. We found a specific gene that was necessary for that process. It's called aquaporin, and it means water channel. A fundamental aspect of much of our work is to use modified viruses as essentially molecular trucks to deliver that bit of DNA into a specific cell. We could take that gene and transfer it into the existing cell in the salivary gland, and that we could restore water movement and the initiation of saliva flow. We're in the process of initiating the next phase of the clinical study, where you expand to look at a larger population of patients. The most rewarding aspect is that I can come in the morning, I can ask fundamental questions that I feel are going to have an impact not only on the advancement of the field of gene therapy, but in developing therapies that are going to have an impact in patients and treat unmet clinical needs.